Hello, hello everyone, welcome to part 2 of modeling the little robot Bella, our little friend. In this part we're going to get into the materials and specifically of the metal, because there's a metal mask, an edgeware mask that is very easy to use for free as well. So that's what I want to show you guys, how to easily use it to make some nice looking metals with some wear. So let's dive right into that. Beautiful, let's add some materials. Now, we're gonna be very simple about this, and this is where the real aim of this tutorial comes into place. Okay, so when I go to Blender Kit, if you don't have Blender Kit, there is a website you can go to, and it is called blenderkit.org. No. Blender kits, just Google it. It'll take you somewhere. .com, of course. You can download the Blender kit. Just like that. You will get a zip file or a Python file. I forgot. Let's see. Download Blender kit. You'll get a zip file. You can just go into Blender, edit, preferences, add-ons, install, and locate your download file of Blender kit, and just install the add-on. It will then appear there if you search for a Blender kit. There it is, the online asset library. You can check the little box in front and save your preferences. And you will now have this little window on top where you can search. All right, so make sure the eye is enabled, otherwise you won't be able to see anything. And now you can just search for a material. For example, metal. We want a metal body of this little guy. And we want it to be a little bit rusty with some edge wear. So let's find some rusty. We can just search for rust as well, and it will locate some nice rusty things for us. All right, so let's find one that we think we can use. I like that. Let's go with a basic one. Perhaps this one is fine. That's a very, very rusty metal. Coarse rust. Nah. I have to remember not to be too picky, so this tutorial won't go on forever. Maybe this one is looking good. All right, I think that will do. What we're just going to do is go to the UV editor. Actually, let's see. UV seems to be working nice. So we can just go into the material tab, locate that mapping node. Why is my Blender so slow right now? Is this material just slow? I'm going to locate a different one. Let's see if it fixes my slow Blender. It did not, in fact, do that. All right, we'll work with it. So this is the one I'm going to use, Metal, Iron, Light, Rust, and Dama. I'm going to set the scale to about 0.3, perhaps. Yeah, it doesn't look nice. Right, now we want some edge wear, because our robot bumps into things, okay? It just happens. So what we're going to do, there's a very nice shader in the Blender kit that we can use for this. Edgeware in Blender has always been a little bit of a struggle. If you use, for example, the, let's see, what is it called? The object info or the geometry? Geometry, you have a pointiness value right there, which will give you some kind of an edgeware vibe, but it will depend on the smoothness of your geometry and stuff like that. So usually it will look quite blocky. So it doesn't really work all the time. Instead, there is a shader that is called wear, edge wear with imperfections. And you also have the standard one that's called edge wear. In my opinion, this one doesn't work as well as this one, because for the usual or the regular one by Sebastian, you have got, it is still pretty much dependent on your geometry, right? And you can see it in the image preview as well. You've got some of those white lines in the curve as well. So at the bottom part there, where it curves back, you have some small white edges as well. In this one, you don't have that. It is a very smooth and takes the thick edges. So if I select that, you can see that now we have just a black and white mask. And that is exactly what I want as well. So black and white mask means that you can use it to control a lot of things. You can use it to control, for example, the mix shader nodes so you have a clean material for those edges or a worn material and a rusty material for the rest. For example, what we need, right? And you can control two values, which is very simple. You've got the general edge wear size, so you can make this bigger, like that. And hold shift if you want smaller increment steps. I'm gonna go with something like that. Right, so what we now have is the mask that we can use for pretty much anything. So what I'm gonna do is hit this plus sign. I'm gonna search for my second material, the one that I actually want to show on my object. And I'm just gonna copy this entire node setup that takes care of the material and this one as well. So Control C, oh, I did not select everything. Here we go, hold shift. Control C or right mouse, copy. And I'll just paste that in the edgeware. Boop, just like that. Now, we can, for example, hit shift A, add a mix shader. Swipe that in there like this, and this one we want this to be controlling the vector. All right, so it's going to control where which material is going to take place, and we want one of those to be the rust. Let's see, there we go. And we can change the scaling if we want, so select everything and select 0.5 or something like that, or maybe a little bit smaller, 0.3, maybe even smaller, 0.15. Starting to look a little bit poor. 0.25, final call. There we go. Now, hit shift A, search for a principal BSDF. And let's set that to metallic with a low roughness and select that and connect it to the second shader, which means that we now have an actual edge and it's going to be very strong because we did not add any bevel at all. But we can now see that the edge of this material is actual metal. Where's my object? There it is. All right, so this is metal. This is like degraded, and we can change the edge wear size if we want. If we want it smaller, if we want it bigger, it will change it. And I will actually add this normal map to the normal metal as well. There we go. And perhaps the displacement can be there as well. There we go. Beautiful. Actually, yeah, nice. So what I'm gonna do is just add a small bevel to my object, all right? Because these edges, these sharp edges, they don't occur in real life. Everything has at least a little bit of a bevel or a wear. So hit a bevel. There we go. And let's just set that amount a little bit lower, or like that. And let's just add a few more segments. 5 is usually what I go with. I know we can increase that or decrease that. You can see that we've got some nice edge wear. Let's control this down a little bit like that. So it actually only controls the, or takes care of the edge part right there. And we can increase the imperfection size. Oh, sorry, the imperfection size. So we get some very nice, I'm not sure what that was. We can have some very nice and edge wear going like that. Isn't that looking way better already? Amazing. Look at that. Beautiful. All right, so you can do that. You can apply that on any material. It doesn't have to be this rust. It can be any kind of rust. I'm actually going to go to my environment texture and play around with it a little bit. So shift our shader to world, select it, hit Control T. If that doesn't work, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and search for a Node Wrangler. Node Wrangler. You gotta enable that and save your preferences. And then you can select it and hit Control T. It will then appear. All right. So now we can actually rotate this around the Z axis to get some crisp reflections, something like that. So I'm going to locate my camera first. I like when we're heading into materials and stuff, I usually find it a good time to position my camera and set up the scene a little bit as well. All right, so I'm going to select this and set this to 90-20, 90-20. So we actually have some kind of a square like that. And we're going to hide the background. So go to your render tab, film transparent. There we go. Hit shift A, add a plane, move that down. This is going to be our ground. Our robot has to stand on something. Scale it up like that. Beautiful. Absolutely amazing. All right, now just extrude that back edge up. like that, select that back edge, hit Control B, and scroll up a few times. So this is going to be smooth, like an actual product render. I think that will look fine. All right, so this blocks the shadow. We can disable that if we want. Go to the object properties and visibility and just disable the shadow tab. All right, so now it will still like catch shadows, for example, of our object and stuff like that. Right, there's still a shadow there, but it won't really catch the light rays from our environment texture, which is perfect because we now still have that strong lighting that comes in the scene. Beautiful, right? So we have some nice degraded metal on that front surface, and we have some nice edge wear there as well, so that you zoom in, you can actually see some beautiful scratches and some nice clean shaven off wear on those edges. Beautiful. Now, of course, we have a very smooth metal. We can just change the color to something more dirty if we want, something more copper or just darker, and up the roughness a little bit because it was a little bit too rough, perhaps. Like that. So now we have some edge wear. Beautiful. Maybe even increase that a little bit. Why not? Edge wear is beautiful. Let's just increase this a little bit. Oh, that was a little bit too much. Yeah, something like 0.05 looks fine. Now we can copy the same material to different parts of the mesh. For example, I want the head to be the same. Ctrl L, link materials. Beautiful. Right, so the head texture is looking quite stretched. Easiest thing to fix that. Press tab, AU cube projection. Right, looking fine. Usually cube projection works quite nice. That is just what I mainly try first in Blender. And if that doesn't work, I will go to manually unwrapping. But if it works, it saves a lot of time. You can also use, for example, the standard projection, which sometimes work nice as well. Not this time, we've got this weird top part. Sphere projection is something you can try. This is, of course, a weird shape for a sphere. You can try all sorts of stuff. Light map project usually works are right as well, so it's going to try to pack it all into a cube, which doesn't work at all because it's going to separate all of these faces individually. You can try volume active quads, usually works mediocre, quite all right actually. If I say so, the top part probably looks like, yep, looks like shit. So unwrap this just as a cube, all right? So that usually works quite well. Nice. Now let's get back into that front view and let's just add a new material. Let's just do that. Actually, let me first bevel these edges a little bit more because I don't like the way they are so hard. Something like that looks better. All right, very nice indeed. Okay, next up, we've got some more materials that we have to take care of. All right, so we have, for example, this. We have the neck parts. I'm not going to take too much time on those inner parts. For example, this neck. I'm just going to make it a metal. Actually, usually things that have to wear less are, I think, cobalt chrome. Do we have that? Just going to take it. Don't know what it specifically is, but it will do. Right, that's fine. Looks nice and metallic. What else? Rotating parts, stuff like that. It can all be some kind of cobalt chrome material. It's very hard. It's also used in hip joints. So it is usually a very nice and hard material. All right. Right, so that is pretty much the metal part of our little robot. So part two is pretty much done now. In the next part, you'll be able to see the results, how we do the rubber part of the robot. The top part is going to be rubber because that is something that it will bump with or fall down on, right? It's the first part that's gonna hit the floor pretty much, so that has to be a little bit dampening. So that's what we're going to focus in to make that look a little bit degraded and customize it a little bit. And we're also going to set up the scene a little bit and play around. All right. So thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, please do leave a like, a comment, or a subscribe. I would appreciate any one of those. All right. See you in the next one.